This is Hockey Talkie, for the week of December 12th to December 16th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Predators started their season very well over in Europe, by scratching and tearing two wins away from the San Jose Sharks. Since then, the kid thinks the Predators have been playing not good, and need to improve, if they want to bounce into the playoff. The Nashville players and management are very lucky that their division is not very good, or some would actually say, pathetic. If the Predators can get goaltending like last year from Juuse Saros, and improve their crazy bad power play, they might be have a slim chance, maybe, to make the playoff. The kids think they can't, and won't, this season. What do you think? Will the
this
Predators...
This is Hockey Talkie, for December 13, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
The Philadelphia Flyers are exactly, yes exactly, where Rogie thought they would be at the start of the season. Out of the playoff. Currently, they are near the bottom of the league with their power play, and they don't have a good penalty kill, either. It is crazy, ugly. Yes, they won't make the playoff this year under coach John Tortorella. Me think, if he remains as coach for year 2 and 3, the Flyers will be in the playoff though. Should Flyer management be patient with Tor, or should they pull the trigger and fire him? What would you do?
This Let is Hockey down. Talkie, for December 14, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
The Winnipeg Jets continue to soar super high in the West Division standings this season. Just like the kid said, they would. December as the Jets, playing 16 games in 31 days. But this will not make them crash, though a little of a dip may occur in their win column flight. Their fantastic new, but old coach, Rick Bowness, deserve a great deal of kudos for having the J players crazy prepared for all of their games. Also, Blake Wheeler is contributing a crazy low more than last year, maybe because he doesn't have the C, pasted on his jersey. One more thing, the kid thinks that the Winnipeg J will continue to fly even higher in the standing, with the return of forward Nicolas Ehlers. What do you think about the Winnipeg J this year, hockey fans?
This is Hockey Talkie, for December 15, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Loser. Wow. Congratulations to Alex Ovechkin, on scoring his 800th NHL goal yesterday. What a fantastic accomplishment, as Alex joins the crazy, fantastic Gordio, and Wayne Gretzky, in reaching the coveted 800 goal mark. The kid believes Ovechkin will pass the great one, Wayne Gretzky, and could reach 1,000 goals in total in his NHL career, if he can stay away from injury. Again, congratulations Alex, and we all look forward to watching you score many more goals for the Washington Capitals in the future.
This is Hockey Talkie, for December 16, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Rogie, the kid, predicted early this season to watch out for the dangerous and stampeding Buffalo Sabres. But they unfortunately went off a cliff, instead of winning hockey games. Not very good, Buffalo. However and more recently, the kid thinks they have found their stride again. With the emergence of their crazy talented young guns of Tash Thompson, Rasmus Dahlin, Jack Quinn, and Dylan Cousin. As well as their more senior looking goaltender, Craig Anderson. I think the kid will be wrong, with my prediction that the Sabres will make the playoff this year. Sorry for that fans. However, I think that my warning at the start of the season still apply to all the other NHL hockey team, watch out for Teze Young, and talented, Buffalo Sabre team. What do you think? Are the Buffalo Sabre going to scare some team, and upset them this year during the regular season?